welcome to some more standard here on Channel Fireball. I've got an Esper Dragons list put together here, and this is what I'll be battling with today. It's a little different from, well, some people's builds. I move towards 4 Dragonlord Ojutai and 1 Dragonlord Selimgar. I don't like Selimgar the Drifting Death. I think the 3-7 is just not quite good enough for standard, and I'd rather have these as my 5 dragons to enable Selimgar's Scorn and Foul Tongue. Foul Tongue is a card I like playing 4 of. I've completely cut ultimate price at this point, relying on 4 Foul Tongue, 2 Heroes Downfall, 3 Bile Blight, as my anti-creature spells, as well as the 2 Crux of Fate. I also only have 1 Anticipate, opting for a 28th land, which right now is an Opulent Palace, but I could see becoming an untapped land of some kind. A second Urborg is definitely possible. Could also rework the mana base a little bit to play like 2 Flooded Strands and also play up Plains. I also like having 1 Dragonlord's Prerogative in the main deck. Very good in the mirror, and just good against people who are Thoughtseizing you. 2 Dissolve, along with the aforementioned 4 Scorn, and then 3 Thoughtseize in the main deck. And that rounds out the main deck, especially with 1 Ashiok as the last kind of threat. No Ugin. I actually don't have Ugin the Spirit Dragon anywhere in this list. And the sideboard reflects that a little bit with 2 Perilous Vaults. I found this card to be better than Ugin in the matchups where I wanted Ugin, basically against the Deathmist Raptor decks and the Green Devotion type decks. Also, the second Dragonlord Selimgar against similar decks, basically green decks, and a Silence the Believers that can also come in if you suspect Risen Executioners in the mirror. I don't like Risen Executioner. I don't think it's a good plan in the mirror, but some people do, so I've got that. I also have Bile Blight, Double Drown and Sorrow against the red decks, as well as Tasker, which comes in against a lot of different decks. Basically, when people take out removal, Tasker gets better. And against control decks, I've got the 4th Thoughtseize, the 1st Duress, 2nd Ashiok, and then 2nd Dragonlords, and then 2 Stratus Dancer, a card that I've been pretty impressed with because it also comes in against red. Alright, in an 8-player queue, let's see how that goes. And I would, in fact, like to play first. And despite the darkness shrouding my hand, I will go ahead and keep this one. Having Thoughtseize and Crux of Fate on the play, especially with a Dig, which is going to get enabled by both Delta and Thoughtseize. I think this hand is reasonable. It's got double blue, all the black I need. Doesn't have white quite yet for Ojutai, but this is just a very keepable hand on the play. Alright, so here I'm still going to lead with Dismal Backwater. I don't really feel like there's that many 1-drops in Standard that I need to be Thoughtseizing on turn 1. And in general, when the mana cost... like, here it's actually not really the mana, because I could have played turn 1 Thoughtseize and just played Backwater turn 2. It would cost me very little. But in general, I feel like you should be like on the play in this situation when you don't really have anything pressing to play on turn 2. Just play your turn 1 land tap and just say go. Alright, gives your opponent more turns to draw things you'd want to Thoughtseize. So I drew the white mana, that's good. So Mystic Monastery, which is most commonly Jeskai tokens. So now it's actually a little more interesting what to do this turn. I'm going to play Polluter Delta and sacrifice it because I don't want to draw islands. And thinning my deck is good if I'm going to have to do that at some point eventually, which I am. Question is, do I Thoughtseize? I get to take something like Seeker of the Way. It gives my opponent more time to draw Jeskai Ascendancy or Goblin Rabble Master if I wait, like the 3 drops that I care about. But you know, the Ascendancy is here anyway, so I'm just going to take Ascendancy, leave my opponent raise Stoke in 4 lands, which is not a spectacular hand. Obviously, the hand is very keepable, especially since some of the lands are Scry lands, but in general, I think that this is a decent hand for me to battle against. So my opponent looks like might be main phasing Raise the Alarm to play around a counterspell, or just they drew a Seeker. Oh, they drew a Seeker, which I'm okay with. Let's get an island. Hopefully draw a 3-drop. Did not draw a 3-drop, and I don't really need to play Urborg, so I'm not going to do that. Might as well not give my opponent's fetch lands an additional ability, even though it's unlikely to matter very much at this point. The good thing is, if my opponent does want to play a Raise the Alarm, this lines up for me to Crux them both. So if I just play for land number 4, pass, my opponent's end of turn Raise the Alarm, hits me at a 12, and that Crux, that is decent for me. So I can't quite cast anything, so I'm just going to pass the turn. Question for my opponent is, are they okay with just attacking with Seeker of the Way? 2 a turn is not really enough to pressure me, so yeah, it does not surprise me that they do this. I could also just cast Ojutai next turn. That is a very reasonable line of play as well. So I'm going to hit for 4 down to 12. And opponent is passing the turn. All right, so I'll draw. So the strand I don't really want to crack because my life total might actually matter in, at this point, and I don't really need to crack another land. I guess I technically didn't need to know I needed to crack Delta, but I think it's safer to crack it first. So now, if I play Ojutai, I'm setting myself to take a little bit more damage, and if I block Seek and my opponent has two spells, that's not good for me. It's also pretty bad if they have Jeskai Ascendancy, so I think I'm just going to play Haven of the Spirit Dragon and Crux of Fate. It's pretty bad for me either way if my opponent has Disdainful Stroke. But I think this plays around more things. My opponent didn't stoke me in a turn and didn't play an instant speed creature in a turn, so that's pretty good for me. So their hand right now is Stoke the Flames X. So two unknowns. If I draw a cheap removal spell, I might play it. Though this actually will play. I can get stoked in response, but if my opponent has any other spell, I get to take it. And if I get stoked basically down to six and my opponent has no spells in hand, that works for me too. The reason this is so good is that I want to be able to block the Seeker of the Way with Ojutai, and I don't want my opponent to play two spells afterwards. Ooh, and they can. Cruise is annoying. All right, I'm just going to take Treasure Cruise, play Urborg, play Ojutai. And here I am going to block the Seeker, despite the fact that my opponent gets to burn me down to four and trade. I think that's better than letting my opponent Treasure Cruise, because I have the Dig Through Time in hand. I have the trump card. What did my opponent draw here? Oh, Jeskai Ascendancy. That's pretty good. So now my opponent gets to attack and cast Wild Slash to trade these two creatures. I technically don't have to block. I could take it. I get Wild Slash down to 8, and then I get hit for 5, so down to 3, but then that makes Stoke lethal. I don't think I like doing that. My opponent's also not getting a ton of value off of the draw discard here, because discarding Stoke the Flames is not great, and so I assume my opponent's going to discard the other card. Though I actually might have kept Anticipate here, since these trade. And now my opponent's got Stoke and Ascendancy, which aren't bad versus my set. I think I'm just going to play this for 4. I want to leave Ojutai there because of Haven. I don't think I need to sack a strand to make it cheaper. All right, Ashiok, Bioblight, Dig Through Time, Solemngar, Scorn, Dissolve. My inclination right now is just to take Dissolve, Dig Through Time, and then play Flooded Strand, leaving Dissolve up. My opponent has Stoke in hand plus nothing. Yeah, I think that's fine. And play Flooded Strand and pass the turn. So now my opponent, if they don't do anything here, I could end of turn get Ojutai back, but then I would be casting Ojutai and be unable to cast anything, so I think I'm just going to wait. I might do that eventually, but there's no reason to do it right now. And let's actually just play the Dismal Backwater, the reason being that if I tap 7 to cast Dig, exiling just the Dig, then Scrying isn't that helpful, and if I get Stoked end of turn, this way I don't die to a double Stoke, so I can tap out for Dig a little safer. Raise the Alarm, that I do not like. Alright, probably going to counter that. I'm going to let my opponent loot first. Basically, if my opponent discards Stoke, that is more dangerous for me, but because they didn't, I'm happy enough just dissolving this. Hero's Downfall. Put that on the bottom. That does not match up all that well against the spells I'm worried about here. Treasure Cruise is the card I'm most worried about. And Hordling Outburst is good, though my opponent took a damage off their land to cast it. I don't know about doing that. I might dig here. So this card Secure the Waste, again keeping Stoke the Flames. Alright. I'm gonna let that resolve. I could sack Flooded Strand to cast Dig here. Yeah, I don't think playing Dragon Lord Ojutai is gonna be that helpful, and if I dig through time, I've got a good shot of finding good things to cast instead, so see you later, Ojutai. Could stoke me down to 4 in response, but then you basically miss the loot and the pump on the goblins, so I don't think you want to do that. Alright, looks like my opponent's in. I'm actually a lot happier this happens, because I didn't really want to counter stoke anyway. This, again, makes it so the loot doesn't do anything, because my opponent has no cards in hand, and now, if my opponent doesn't draw a spell, then the goblins don't even get bigger next turn. So So I'm at 4. So if I take Dragonlord Ojutai and cast Ojutai, then I do die to any spell. So I probably don't want to do that. I could take Dragonlord Silumgar. The question is, if I take Silumgar, what's the other card do I take? Do I take Ojutai? Do I take Dragonlord's Prerogative? Do I take Anticipate? I think I'm going to take Silumgar and Dragonlord's Prerogative. Because Prerogative and Dig Through Time cost similar amounts right now, I'd rather just take the one that draws me more cards. And I think it's safest just to play the Dragonlord here. That way there's very little I actually just die to. And then actually I drew Dismal Backwater, so now I don't even die to a top deck Stoke. Again, Treasure Cruise could be very bad for me, but there aren't that many cards my opponent could draw that really just wreck me. I guess a Valorous Stance on Dragonlord Silumgar is pretty bad. Alright, Jeskai Ascendancy is decent, but again, no looting means that it's not that harmful. And trading a goblin for a goblin if they want is not great either. I mean, it's a decent line, but I could actually not block the second goblin. Is that better? And then go to 3, but I don't really want to die to burn spells. And there's a decent chance that I find a removal spell off of the prerogative here. I think I can cast it without scrying. Actually, you know, at this point, I'd rather just scry first. Yeah, let's put this on the bottom. If you don't care too much what you get, then scrying first is not necessary. But I'm in a spot where I actually do want to make sure I draw something good. All right. Let's, I think, just Foul Tongue this now. Oh, probably should tap for black. So then I go up to 9. I don't die to any spell. I'm going to hit my opponent down to 20, but I've got 3 Scrylands, an Ashiok, and a Silumgar against no cards in hand, though 2 Ascendancies in play is a big game. With no cards in hand to begin with, unless my opponent draws Treasure Cruise, it's not that fierce. I actually don't think my opponent wanted to cast that there. Because you're not getting any value off the loots, having a third Ascendancy in play is really not that relevant. I would just wait, because that way you get many more digs for Treasure Cruise. Not even Dig Through Time, just actual digs. Whereas if you wait a turn, yeah, and you draw and you cast that, you get to draw, discard, draw, discard, draw, discard. So Ashiok is decent. I don't have any dragons to get back with Haven right now. Yeah, Ashiok doesn't do a ton, but it could hit a Rabble Master or something. Did I get anything good? No. Temple. Bottom. Smash. So now I'm really just looking to find a counterspell to make sure I don't get burned out, or to counter a Treasure Cruise, more importantly. Oh, there's the Treasure Cruise. Well, I guess if you're just going to peel the Treasure Cruise, casting Ascendancy is a good play. But in general, I don't think casting Ascendancy last turn was what my opponent wanted to do. Ashiok betrayed me. All right, so now my opponent's got a lot of gas. And with 3 Ascendancy in play, he's going to get to see a lot more cards. So now I actually do need to find a counterspell pretty quickly, or I'm just going to get buried by Treasure Cruises. So, opponent only has 2 left. That's good. And I do have a Bioblight to counter basically the instant speed card that comes out in a turn. Ooh, finding a Dissolve is nice. Alright, no more. No hits there either. Dragonlord Ojutai. I think Ojutai is okay. There aren't that many cards I want here. Dig Through Time, Ojutai. I already use the Dragonlord's Prerogative, so I think it's worth putting Ojutai on top, even though I'd rather have a Dig Through Time. So I expect an end of turn. Looks like... Oh, Stoke the Flames. All right. That I'm probably going to let resolve. Can't stop my opponent from looting anyway. It's going to be... Basically, I want to counter Treasure Cruise. I don't want to counter anything else. My opponent is they choosing not to loot? Interesting. No. Maybe they chose not to loot on one of them. Alright. And Stoked down to 5. Bioblight can counter token making, though if my opponent has enough mana to cast a second spell in response to Bioblight, the Ascendancy's actually stopped that too. But Cruise is the card that concerns me here. Not, yeah, like Hordling Outburst, for example. I'm drawing Ojutai. Opponent still staying at 2 cards in hand here. Let's see what they end up with. So they discarded. Yeah, Seeker of the Way. Not all that great right now. Basically, when they start discarding burn spells, then it becomes a little more dangerous, but... Alright, so the question is, do I Bioblight end of turn? I think I'm drawing an Ojutai, so that doesn't change much. I'm not going to do anything in response, I guess. Let's just draw Ashiok, my opponent. Hitting a creature would be nice at some point, though. I guess Ashiok is getting high up there. All right, let's play Temple. Well, play Ojutai. Guess don't really want to tap the Dragonland, I suppose. Now I have enough mana up for Bioblight and Dissolve. So now I'm just going to pass the turn because I can block the goblins and it won't be lethal. And if my opponent casts something end of turn, I get to Bioblight in response. Basically, I force my opponent to cast the first spell. I think that's better. And even if that, because I'm drawing Dig Through Time, even if they do have something else here, I feel like I'm in okay shape. So Wild Slash. So here, I think I want to do it in response to looting, because I don't want my opponent to have an opportunity to loot into another playable spell. And even if my opponent has the spell, which they think they had last turn, they were leaving mana up anyway. So they play a spell now. But I don't die. Actually, is that accurate? Lightning Strike and the Bioblight basically cancel each other out in terms of ascendancies. And then I take 6, so I get to counter Lightning Strike, but then I still die. Yes, I actually still do die here. Because the tokens end up as 4/4s and I'm taking 2 off Wild Slash. Alright. Against tokens in general, I just like to board in a couple drowns. Ashiok is not good. Actually, don't mind Dragonlord's Prerogative or Stratus Dancer. Hero's Downfall is generally not good. Foul Tongue is generally not good. Bioblight is very good. Dress is quite good. Dragonlord Silumgar is kind of medium. This is like the one matchup where you want the Drifting Death. Do I want Perilous Vault? Perilous Vault is okay, actually. Take out an Anticipate. I don't know if I want... Maybe I don't want all the Hand Disruption. Crux of Fate's actually kind of medium, too. I think I'll take out the Crux of Fate and then just put in the Thought Seizes. Alright. Alrighty. Let's go ahead and play first. And, yeah, a very cute bull hand. Bioblight against... Early action, some scry lands, and a dig through time. It's got a lot of lands in it, but this is still a fine two spell, five land hand, because two lands scry and the two spells are good, so I will allow it. Alright, let's go ahead and play Temple of Deceit. And probably keeping most spells, definitely bidding any land. I even have black, black, blue, blue, white. Alright, Ojutai is good. The other thing to mention is I do expect that there's a good chance my opponent boarded in Dragonlord Ojutai and has counters in their deck, so that's why I like having my own, like all the Thought Seizes. Still don't want to land even a scry land. And even though I took out all the Foul Tongues, having counter spells plus Thought Seizes plus Perilous Vault I think is enough to hedge against Ojutai. I could leave in a couple Foul Tongue invocations because they do kill Seeker of the Way and, depending on the timing, Rabble Master or Mentor. Let's play Bioblight, even though my plan is to not use Bioblight on the Seeker that's hitting me for 2. I might as well leave it up and then next turn play Temple. If my opponent plays something to make Seeker hit for more, I might change my tune, though. Alright. Temple. Alright, I still like Bioblight here. Now, I'm much more likely to use Bioblight. Still probably do it for 2, though. Might as well wait till end of turn. Or still rather take 2 and wait till end of turn. I don't think that I'm getting a whole lot of value by... Well, I've got double blue. Interesting. Casting Bioblight early, and now I have the opportunity to cast Drown in Sorrow instead, if I would like. Which Does Camellia not get Disdainful Stroked? Often Disdainful Stroke's the counter they have the most of post-board, though I would not be surprised if they had a negate or something. Could also Bioblight something and then untap and play Ojutai. Actually, I'm just going to Bioblight the Seeker of the Way. Part of the reason I'm doing this is, first of all, drawing another Bioblight. Second, if I play Drowning Star, my opponent has any spell, the Seeker, like I anticipate even, the Seeker survives. So I think it's worth doing this, using my mana this turn. And if I'm only taking two here, I can just go ahead and try to cast Ojutai, and I don't feel as bad if it gets countered. I'm not super worried about... I mean, this may not resolve into a Disdainful Stroke, but Dig Through Time is, I think, a little more important. Yep, here's Disdainful Stroke. Get to pass the turn. Again, not incredibly worried about getting hit for two, and I can cast Dig Through Time at some point here. Duress or Thoughtseize would be pretty nice, though. Just gonna play a land and say go. I would like to cast this Dig Through Time at some point here. It's on four cards. I think I just take it going to 12, and then opponent doesn't do anything. I'm just going to draw for my turn. Alright, I think now we're just going to cast Drown in Sorrow. Let's see if we fight over it. Alright, Dissolve I like. Yeah. I'm not planning on casting Bioblade this turn. I want to have all my mana up for next turn. And I'm still representing a counterspell here, so I hope my opponent doesn't go for like a Treasure Cruise. Alright, so this is the game I like. Play my land, pass the turn. And I can cast both Dissolve and Dig Through Time here, so it's a decent chance at the end of my opponent's turn I want to cast both, but because I have Bioblade to answer some of my opponent's instants, I think I could just wait. Again, I've got a bunch of Thoughtseizes and Duresses, and those reward me pretty well for waiting. Though, drawing a second Dig Through Time means that now I think I can fire one off end of turn. And I think I actually just fired off by paying 8. I'm not going to fight over it here, so I think I want to just pay 8. There's not much my opponent can resolve at instant speed that I care about. That's one drawback to having Treasure Cruise be your delve spell of choice. If this gets countered, which I fully expect it to... Okay, getting stoked in response is fine. Then I get to untap and have more action up. Opponent could side in more removal. All right. Wow, this hand is action. I don't want Silumgara, and I don't want Thoughtseize as much as Duress, definitely. The question is, do I want Stratus Dancer, Duress? Actually, I think I want Duress, Dragonlord's Prerogative. I have a lot of counters in my deck post-board. I want to find more of them. Let's Duress my opponent here. Wild Slash and two lands. All right, well, that's not incredibly intimidating. I'm feeling pretty good about this. So now I'm going to cast Dig Through Time, leaving Dissolve up. And leave Ojutai there. And this is something that I've played a lot from the token side, and I don't really get having Wild Slash in your deck post-board here. It doesn't make that much sense to me. All right, so I'm at 4, so I'm actually going to take Silumgar, Scorn, and Dismal Backwater here. Don't want Thoughtseize, my opponent has no cards in hand. And I would much rather, I don't really need Drown because I have this Bioblight. I'd rather get out of Stoke range here. So I go up to 5. Now I've got a bunch of Dissolves up. I'm probably just going to wait on this Dig Through Time because if I wait a turn, I have, Dragonlord's Prerogative because now I have Dissolve up. Actually, I think it might be better to cast Dig anyway, because Dragonlord's Prerogative does eventually become uncounterable, so... Sorry, Ojutai. You are out of here. Alright, let's take Ojutai. Could take Bioblight? I don't really want Perilous Vault at this point. I guess actually I'll just take a land. Land seems good to me. Don't really want to discard, and I don't really want to cast Thoughtseize. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9. So if I play my 10th land, I get to have cast Ojutai with a Dissolve and Silumgar's Scorn up here. And this should be good enough to end the game, given that my opponent doesn't have that many outs just to kill me, and I've got 3 hard counters in hand. I'll pass on casting Thoughtseize, though. I think if my opponent had main phase spells to cast, they would cast them. And if they have all instants and I Thoughtseize, then they just cast all their instants in response. All I did was put myself dead to Lightning Strike or Stoke the Flames for no real good reason. Another Silmgar Scorn. That ought to do it, is my guess. Barring my opponent having something like a Rending Volley. I'll just take Haven. And I think I'm just discarding here the Thoughtseize. Udutai causing me to discard. Pretty unlucky, honestly. Ooh, Whirling Outburst. Sure. Not enough to discard, at least. So I get to Bioblet end of turn and then untap and draw an extra card off Udutai. Negate, I will dissolve the negate. Keep Stratosdancer on top. I kind of don't like drawing Stratosdancer and playing it, though my opponent already has Wild Slash in their deck, so I don't know. I'm just going to take Silmgar Scorn. I don't really need to draw extra cards here. I actually don't need to show my opponent Stratosdancer either. I've got more counter spells than my opponent has cards, essentially, because I'm assuming my opponent has at least one dead card in hand. And I think just hitting my opponent to death with Odrtai with all these counter spells is better than playing a Stratosdancer. No reason for my opponent to think I've got targets. Just taking another Haven of the Spirit Dragon, I suppose. Though I could have just taken a second Odrtai, just in case my Odrtai does get a Rending Volleyed and then I am out of Silmgar Scorn ammunition or dragons to reveal, but I think this will be fine. All right. Did I want to board any differently? Still don't love the idea of Foul Tongue Invocation. Tasigur could actually be great here. If we're both just sitting there doing nothing and my opponent doesn't have many ways to get rid of Tasigur does sound kind of good. Maybe I just go to one Perilous Vault because it just costs so much mana and it's sorcery. I think I want to keep the dragons for Silmgar Scorn, though I could see just playing one less Dragon Lord Silmgar. Yeah, kind of like that. Alright, quite acceptable hand here. I would like to scry into a blue source, but other than that, I'm feeling pretty good about this. Got some Bio Blades to survive. Alright, Temple of Enlightenment. That actually solves both my problems, which are that I wanted a blue source and a white source. Dual lands, powerful. Probably looking to Bio Blight this Seeker of the Way here. Let's play the Urbog. I'll let my opponent attack me. Maybe they'll play like a token pre-combat or something. I actually think I might take two here. No, my opponent's not going to play two Seeker of the Ways, and I want to do this anyway, so let's just Bioblade here. I do take extra damage off negate, but if my opponent wants to negate this, I'm actually okay with that. Using different pictures of negates? Oof. Alright, so I go to 17 now, but then I get to untap and probably go Bioblight Temple. If I draw blue, untap blue, I probably play that. Let's play this. Yeah, Silmgar Scorn seems fine here. Let's just Bioblight. Can't counter anything anyway. Alright. Really didn't want my opponent to play a threat that turn, so now I have counter up. I'm looking for exactly that, though. More blue mana, so now I can have Dissolve plus Silmgar Scorn, or later Dissolve plus Dissolve up. Question is, do I counter like a Raise the Alarm? I don't counter-anticipate, certainly. Raise the Alarm is a little interesting. I'm at 17, so I can take a couple hits for sure, but I would rather my opponent just not cast Raise the Alarm here. Yeah. I don't love countering this, but I think I do. I just have so many counters in hand and I kind of want to sit here for a while, so I still think I keep that on top as well. The downside of countering Raise the Alarm is my opponent gets to resolve like a Jeskai Ascendancy or a Treasure Cruise. Let's see what it turns out to be. Or no, it looks like I was going to say, is that a Ojutai, but no, it's Treasure Cruise. The upside is I do just still have the long game. I mean, that is what like my opponent has cards like Lightning Strike and Wild Slash and Stoke the Flames in their deck. They're just not good when you're sitting there in a game like this when I'm at 17 and not taking any damage, which is another reason to counter Raise the Alarm, by the way. I like dissolving that one too. Alright, Silumgar Scorn is good still. And even though my opponent does have the four Treasure Cruises, I have four Dig, two Dragonlord Prerogative. I've got a bunch of Thoughtseize and Duresses. So, I think it ends up, I have more lands. I have 28 to my opponent's assumed 24, potentially 25. 24 or 25 after board. So, Seeker of the Way. That one, I think I will allow 17. Now, one of the weaknesses to Silumgar Scorn is, even though I have Ojutai, if I play Ojutai, Silumgar Scorn cannot protect Ojutai. So I can't play Ojutai and have Scorn back up until I find second Ojutai, or until I know Ojutai is going to resolve. Tassigar, on the other hand, is exactly what I want. Yeah, I actually think I tap out for Tassigar here or fully delve, because if my opponent counters Tassigar, then I'm just going to slam Ojutai. Though alternately, I could. No, I'd rather just play Ojutai here. I could Disdainful Stroke that and then have a Tassigar in play, but I'd rather have Ojutai in play with Silumgar Scorn in hand. If my opponent does not have an answer, then that's pretty good. Alright, well, I kind of don't want to run into Stoke the Flames, so I'm just going to wait here. My opponent's not doing anything, and now because I have Ojutai in play, I don't need to counter some of the weaker token-making type stuff. I'd rather just wait till I draw Duress or something along those lines. And it keeps my opponent's mana tied up. I don't actually want Perilous Vault here, because here I'm in a fight where if my Ojutai connects, I think I'm going to win. So, Perilous Vault does not help me do that. Like, I'm keeping four of my opponent's mana kind of on lockdown here, because I'm assuming my opponent has Stoke with a counter backup. So, alright. It's going to be hard for my opponent to counter twice, so unless my opponent has Valorous Stance with double counter backup, this ought to work out. So let's cast Silumgar Scorn. I'm expecting a negate here. And then I get to counter that, and then I get to draw three. Well, look at my top three, draw one, but that's close enough at this point, right? It's also possible my opponent doesn't have a counter here, in which case, yeah, they're in trouble. All right, well. Boom. So, opponent does have a window, depending on what I draw. Stratus Dancer. Alright. Well, I'm just going to cast this face down. I'm not really worried about Wraths. And if my opponent then main phase Wild Slashes or Lightning Strikes the Stratus Dancer, I'm okay with that too. If my opponent can't kill Ojutai here, they're in huge trouble. I'm like kind of assuming that my opponent can already kill Ojutai. Yeah, if they could have killed Ojutai, they would have. So, now I'm just hitting again with Ojutai. There's absolutely no reason to wait there, so. Let's take Tassigar. And let's see. I have 1, 2, 3, 4. So if I sack both deltas, I can play Tassigar and activate twice, which is pretty awesome. Just get islands. But actually, I guess I could leave something for Flooded Strand to get, but I have Urborg Gods, so I don't really even need to do that. I'm going to leave Silumgar Scorn in the graveyard because that's the card I want most. And if my opponent's got a Disdainful Stroke, so be it. Alright. So basically what my opponent needs to draw is Treasure Cruise into Stoke the Flames. But they're not doing that, and every turn things are getting way worse for them. Yeah, Dig Through Time does also do that. Let's hit with Ojutai. Yeah, I'm going to take Thoughtseize. I'm in enough life that the life isn't a big deal, and if my opponent has nothing, which they don't, they just have two lands, I think ensuring that they couldn't have a disdainful stroke to stop Dig Through Time is a pretty big deal. Because now I can dig into, well, hopefully counters, but I guess I'll just take Dig Through Time, and I don't care about Bioblade. Though I suppose Bioblade plays around like my opponent drawing Secure the Wastes. And Dig Through Time is enough action that I feel like even if my opponent drew a Stoke and killed Ojutai, or drew Cruise and a Stoke to kill Ojutai, Dig would help get me out of that. Alright, so this looks... I like Dragonlord's Prerogative, but... I think actually Stratosdancer is going to be better here. Yeah, now that Stratosdancer's out, there's really not much my opponent can do to get back into this. All right. Oof, tough match, but ended up winning.